everybody. This is Jason Crazy Bear, filming live from Pleasant Grove, Little Texas, North Carolina, or as I call Okadichi Saponi Homelands. So this video was inspired by a challenge or an invitation from my Auntie Pure Faye up in Canada. She was doing her social distancing thing, and she was showing live videos of five element and five animal Qigong. And so I said, I had mentioned the nine brocades of silk Qigong, and she said, go for it. So I'm about to try to teach you, which is actually the eight brocades of silk Qigong, but the ninth one is standing meditation. So that's the first Qigong I ever learned, was what they call standing meditation. And I'm going to teach you the movement as well as the breathing. So in most of these Qigong meditations, as you go up to the heavens, you breathe that energy or that medicine into your lungs. And as you go down to the earth, you exhale it. And in some ways, you're giving it back to the earth. So I'm going to do four breaths of each. You can do four, sevens, tens, whatever count you like. Probably the longer and the more, the healthier. But I'm just going to do four directions of each breath in each style so that you can have an understanding. So the standing meditation is basically bend the legs a little bit, have them shoulder width apart, and let your hands relax freely by your waist. And you breathe in, going up through the nose and out, going down through the mouth, in, out, in, out, in, out. So the first of the eight silken brocades, and the reason they're called the silken brocades is because silk is very fine cloth. And so as you do these breathing exercises, you're bringing that fine cloth of health into your body. So the first one is two hands.
Hold up to heaven.
Hold up to heavens. So basically start. Make that same shoulder width stance. And as you're going up again, you're breathing in. As you push to the heavens, begin breathing out. In. Out. In. Out, in, and the second one I believe is draw the bow and shoot at the vulture, and that takes a little bit of wider stance, what's called a horse stance, which is a little wider than the shoulder length stance. It's a You got to imagine yourself sitting on the back of a horse, how your legs would be positioned. So same way, we're going to make that stance. And you can always breathe as you're going into the stance. So in, out, in, out. In, out, in, out, in. And some practitioners will do an in-out with each stance. So they'll draw the bow. In. I was taught to just take a stance and just aim the bow in either direction. The third one, I believe, is
separating
the heaven and earth. And so this is very cool. It's the shoulder length stance again. You're basically breathing in as heaven and earth come together and cross, and out as heaven and earth are separated. So in, out, in, out, in, out, in, out. And again, that's separating heavens and earth.
Wise owl.
Oh, one of my favorites. Wise owl gazes back or looks behind. And this is simply bend the knees a little bit. The knee bend is just simply so you're not standing at any point with your knees locked. If your body stands too sharp or too locked, the energy is unable to flow. So you always just put a little arc into your knees. Shoulder length. And you got to imagine the wise owl's wings. And you know how those owls can turn all the way around and see what's behind them. So in. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. Wise owl gazes behind or looks back. This one is the bear shakes his head or sways his head and shakes his tail. So again, this one takes the wide horse stance. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. So you basically breathe in as you sway the head and out as you shake the tail while turning your head. That brings us to two hands touch the toes to heal the kidneys. So that one I do the shoulder length. And you start and you breathe air into the kidneys. And this is almost a little different because you're actually breathing in as you're going down and breathing out as you're coming up. So start at the kidneys. Breathe in as you go all the way down. Your legs touch the toes. Begin to breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in. And because it was so long ago that I learned this, I believe there's a way where you do the energy flow the opposite. So as you're going down, traditionally, like I taught in standing meditation, you breathe out. And then breathe in. So it's just the same thing, just backwards. The next one is the angry face. You can tell me, sweetheart.
Clenched face.
Clenched fist with an angry face.
Yep.
And so again, that takes the traditional horse stance or mabu. Breathe in as you change, and out as you push. So as you clench the fence, breathe in. And the final one is just to kind of like take all that breath and all that energy and all that alignment that you've developed this beautiful morning, and it's called bouncing on the toes. So you stay with your toes connected with that little bit of bend. You go up on the toes to breathe in and fall back on them when you breathe out. Just kind of shake out your whole body. Breathe in. Breathe in. Breathe in. So again, we usually do that in the morning. It's a little bit like our sunrise ceremony or our chinupa or pipe ceremony that we do first thing in the morning in our indigenous culture here on Turtle Island. Most of these arts come from the indigenous cultures of Asia, specifically China. And before they were used as warrior arts, several of the monks and Taoists and Buddhists there used them to heal the body. And why they were trying to heal the body is because they meditated for several hours a day. And they realized that if you do so much meditating, the body starts to deteriorate. And so I believe it was... someone from the East, I think from the Middle. I love that you guys are meditating. I love that you guys are praying for so long, but your body's gonna fail. So he showed them these several arts of breath and muscle and stretching and enhancing the body so that they were able to meditate and pray more. So again, this is just a gift I'm giving you while you're out there quarantining, social distancing, spending a lot of time with your family. This can be done at any age. You can do this with your children. Breath is not going to hurt them. You can even do this with your elders and old ones. And I just want to say, as somebody who is working at what they call an essential business, and coming home to visit my family, the social distancing, don't give up hope. We'll be all right. And I love all you people, and I'll be trying to add more of these things from time to time. Thank you, Pure Faye, for, I won't call it a challenge, I'll call it an invitation. And let's think of more creative ways to help and heal the people. I hope.